A very warm greetings to my dear students. In continuation of our journey regard to basic concepts of computerized accounting, its importance and its scope, now we are moving one more sphere of computerized accountancy entrance and its efficacy, right? So in previous sessions we have discussed regard to importance of scope of computerized accounting regard to financial accounting area, regard to cost accountancy area, right? Now today we are moving to the next sphere of this accounting phase called as computerized accounting in management accounting area. Yeah, management accounting is the third most branch of accountancy field. Earlier we have discussed regard to financial accounting is concerned with ascertainment of profit and loss and depiction of a financial position, whereas cost accountancy ascertainment of or computation of cost of production, computation of cost of elements and cost control mechanism survey. Now as per today's topic, management accounting, this is the third branch. Management accounting is a branch of accounting concerned with preparation of accounting information, facilitating management to take better decisions to utilize the resources in an optimum way. So this is a branch concerned with preparation of accounting information, and it starts where the accounting phase of financial accounting and cost accountants phases elicits management accounting phase starts. I mean, after ending of financial accounting and cost accounting, management accounting activity will take place. It takes inputs of both financial accounting and cost accounting and provides information to the management. So the management is the key base for taking decisions and implementing and look after the organization resources towards achievements of organization goal. That's why this information is being made for management. That's why this is called as management accounting. Don't mean that management accounting means accounting provided by or accounting activity carried out by the management. It is also carried out by the accountant, called as management accountant. The information or the output you are getting from this branch will be useful to the management for to its day-to-day operations for taking decisions for better monitoring of the assets and resources of the business organization. After advent of computerized accounting, management accounting aspects were become very easy and most suitable way. Right? The topics we are discussing in this slide are generally meant for management accounting tools and techniques. After computerized accounting entrance, they become very useful and very friendly environment and very easy and speedy manner. Right? We will discuss one by one. First, financial statement analysis. Any statement that shows financial information is called as financial statement. Right? You can take the example of trading account, profit and loss account, consignment account. You have some income and expenditure account. You have some realization account, right? So all these accounts. The next one, balance sheet, right? So these are comes under financial statement, right? So the information being its nature by financial. That's why it is called as financial statement. What it mean by analysis? Deep understanding and deep examination of a report or a thing is called as analysis. It includes comparative statement. I mean, it includes comparative stage. It includes cause and effect relation identification, and it includes estimation or forecasting. So comparative or comparison, cause and effect relationship identity, and forecasting and estimation can be together called as analysis. So financial statement analysis is a process being carried out by management accounting regard to find out the actual position of each item or element shown in the financial statement. For example, we have shown sales rupees 5 lakhs. What it means? the total sales incurred over a period of one academic year, I mean one accounting year, is to be that 5 lakhs. This is as per financial accounting. Whereas management accounting, it compares with what was the actual sales target. Do we overcome that? I mean, do we realize our target? Is it excess to our target? Is it a deficit to our target? Do we are performing normally or underachievement? What its actual position? Do are these actual sales? What is the gross sale portion? What is the net sales? How much of sales returns taken place? These are some important questions to be answered through financial statement analysis. In case of balance sheet, we simply saying balance sheet total, for example, 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs means 10 lakhs assets. Among these 10 lakhs, what are the useful assets? What are the portion of current assets? What is the portion of fixed assets? What are the quotient of, intangible assets? Coming to the liability side, what are the liabilities to be met immediately within the year? Short-term nature, long-term nature, owner's capital, borrowed capital. Such questions can be answered by making financial statement analysis. In traditional management accounting system, you are supposed to prepare financial statements in a particular way called as a comparative statement or one-way statement or a horizontal statement. Some kind of statements you are supposed to prepare manually. By using computers in management accounting area, we can simply convert the so-called traditional trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet in a moment of no time into your required way. I mean to say, computerized accounting facilitates us to analyze financial statement within no time or with a single moment of time. In traditional days, we can compare two or three periods data only. But in using computerized accounting, by providing, as we discussed in financial accounting area, multiple column presentation, by activating that facility or multi-company program, activating that feature, you can compare all the financial statements with a speedy and beautiful way, right? So financial statement analysis now very easy task by using computerized accounting. The next one, we have some ratio analysis. A ratio is the mathematical relationship between two given variables or two given values, right? So mathematical relations, right? We can compare the relationship mathematically by using ratios, by using times, by using percentages. These are some expressed values for better understanding and better comparison of any given data. So ratio analysis principles are same. You can use the same principle either management accounting or computerized accounting. But by using computerized accounting, you will get these answers within a single moment of time. You can get this ratio analysis results of a particular statement, of a particular company, of a particular period, or more than a company, or more than a period, or more than a statement. You can simply compare 5 balance sheets of same company. You can simply compare by converting it to ratios of 5 companies. 5 different companies also, right? So many kind of inclusiveness is possible by using management accounting, particularly in computerized area. So you can simply perform ratio analysis and get the reports on your own choice as per your requirement. The next one, cash flow statement. See, the name itself, it is a statement that that depicts cash flow of a particular company over a period of time. Over a period of time limit, right? So it will accounts what are the sources that made to cash inflow into the organizations and what are the ways that made cash outflow from the company. So for a period of particular time, you can prepare cash flow statement for a day, for a week, or a month, or a year also. In case of traditional management accounting system, it will take a lot of time because you are supposed to prepare cash from operations. You are supposed to prepare them cash flow statement. You are supposed to prepare balance sheet. In order to opening balance sheet and closing balance sheet, in order to find out the impact, right? So in manual accounting system, this could be a cumbersome and a lengthy process. As computers are provided a sophisticated program for this purpose, You can get cash flow statement by pressing a single button. I'm saying simply by pressing, I mean simply cash flow statement or a single button, you will get a cash flow statement for a day. I mean, without any human involvement, without any procedural task, by using computerized accounting, you will get this cash flow statement at any moment of time as you need it. So this is made very easy to the management accountant and the management to get the cash flow statement, right? So cash flow statement will help you in working capital management also. And it will facilitate you to how much of amount to be maintained for the day-to-day expenditure. The excess investment in working capital or underinvestment in working capital will ultimately dilute your achievements. That's why cash flow statement facilitate you in a better way and in a speedy way. The next one, you have some funds flow statement. Cash flow statement only concerned with pure cash. I mean, cash and cash in hand and cash at the bank somewhat. Some organizations used to prepare only cash in hand, and some organizations used to prepare cash in hand and cash at bank. That is their choice and requirement. Computerized accounting facilitates which kind of you think, right? If you want to prepare only cash in the hand, you need to select only the cash in hand in your software. Right? The next one, fund is nothing but it is the combination of both current assets and current liabilities. Gross working capital concept means the total of current assets is called as gross working capital. I'm saying the total sum of current assets of a company is called as a gross working capital. Net working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. I mean, after deducting current liabilities, the amount of current assets available is called as net working capital, right? Say here, fund means working capital. Remember that fund means working capital. Again, gross fund and net fund. You can prepare this statement in a gross way, means current assets, but in practice, they are used to prepare this as net working capital only. I mean, considering both current assets and current liabilities, that is called as funds flow statement. This is a statement that depicts the information regard to on what ways the flow of fund taken place in a given period of time, inflow and outflow also, right? For example, how fund can be flow into our organization. If you raise capital that is in the form of cash, it is an indicator of, I mean to say, student, remember that what activity affects either current asset or current liability will result into funds inflow or outflow. If you raise share capital that is in the form of cash, definitely that is the result of funds inflow. If you pay a loan, that is the result of funds outflow. In a traditional system, you are supposed to prepare funds from operations and funds flow vis-a-vis statement, balance sheet and cash account. All after completion of all tasks, you can get what is the net fund flow happened over a period of select period. Right? By using computerized accounting, as we discussed in the case of cash flow statement, you can get funds flow statement within no moment of all. And you will get the information on your fingertips simply by pressing or by activating and by pressing and by accommodating. You can customize your funds flow statement to a week of time, to a single day of time, to a month or to a year. Of course, within a day also you can get either cash flow statement or funds flow statement without any interpretation of data, without any further feeding of data. By simply accounting process starts with the data entry we are discussing so far. Right, by simply entering one-time transactions, you will get all the information in the form of financial accounting and in the form of management accounting area also. Both cash flow and funds flow statements are important tools in working capital management or short-term capital management or operation capital management, what it may be. Right? So this could provide what is the actual current position, particularly current status of your current assets and current liabilities in a wonderful way. The next one, report breakup and synchronization. See, as per Companies Act, companies are supposed to prepare its financial statements regard to 3 months time period. I mean, quarterly, right? So you are supposed to prepare first quarter statements, accounts, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter. At the time of fourth quarter, you are supposed to show all quarter 1, 2, 3, 4 and consolidated statement also. I mean consolidated column also. This is somewhat merging of financial statements. Whereas you want to break up your statement. For example, you have some cash account for the year, total year. You want to know the cash account data, particularly from January to March, 3 months, or quarter one, I mean April, May, June only. So this is called as report breakup. In traditional management accounting, you're supposed to use a pen, a paper, and involving human, human effort, you will get that. In case of computerized accounting, almost all kinds of computerized software providing this facility, you can break up your report into half yearly, quarterly, monthly, weekly, fortnightly, weekly, daily, and hourly also. Right? And month report breakup and synchronization. Synchronization in the sense, getting integrated many more reports into it. For example, you have a report of quarter one. You have a report of quarter three. You want to merge quarter one and quarter three, and you want to know the impact of quarter one and three together. This is called as synchronization, right? So breakup and synchronization is one kind of data analysis, particularly financial statement analysis nowadays using by the companies and so-called concerns, right? So you can simply break up and you can synchronize your statements in an easy way to get the information pertaining to the report breakup and synchronization aspects. The next one, responsibility accounting through budgetary control. Yeah. Say management accounting objectives, if you go through in your literature, there is a word, stewardship accounting, means the people, particularly managements, are the trustees who are supposed to safeguard the resources as well as the interest of various stakeholders. So this is their primary responsibility, to safeguard the interest of the stakeholders and to utilize effectively various resources available to that organization. That's why responsibility accounting being practiced through budgetary control mechanism. Budgetary control. Budget means setting a target of an expense or an income. Say, I'm saying budget is a tool, one kind of planning, right? As per your management theorems. So budget is a tool that is used to set a standard or target of an expense, of an expenditure, or of an income or a revenue. So by setting a target, you are assigned to that target, then the actuals to be compared with that target. If any deviations happened, it is to be corrected. The next you are supposed to set again that budget. Right? So budgetary control mechanism is a important, practicing, very widely practicing tool in management accounting regard to controlling over of expenses and boosting of revenues also. You can put a sales budget that will boost your sales revenue. You can put a salaries budget that will control your expenditure, indirect expenditure, right? So this is the mechanism, right? It involves four stages: setting standards, allocation of funds or activity, monitoring of activity, comparison of activity with budgets, identifying the deviations and controlling over. Same, you can see that in control function of management. Right? So in management accounting, there are hardly two to three years areas will be identified, and budgetary control mechanism being used to control over that. In case of computerized accounting, you can set standards for all aspects. You can set, for example, if you are running a manufacturing organization, you can put a budgetary control mechanism for material cost, labor cost, and you can put a budgetary control mechanism for overheads, category wise, factory overheads, office overheads, sales overheads, what it may be. You can put budgetary control for all kinds of, indirect expenses also. Salaries it may be, depreciation it may be, financial expenses like interest, budgetary control for bad debts. Same as you can put budgetary control mechanism for revenues also, sales revenue or sales budget, working capital budget. Dear students, budgetary control mechanism can be applied to the all aspects of a business concern. If you want to apply these tasks to the all aspects of the business organization, it will take a lot of time and involvement of human and equipment. But simply using a standard computerized accounting software, you can activate the budgetary control by simply in two or three steps. Simply, you are supposed to activate budgetary control option first. You are supposed to set budgetary targets to the concerned accounts or cost centers or revenue centers, and the remaining task will be completed by the computer itself. Simply two. You are supposed to activate, you are supposed to create and enter, I mean set the target. For example, I want to set a target for salaries, right? Simply, I have to activate budgetary control first, then I have to set a salary target, define initially. After entering the day-to-day transactions, the budgetary control mechanism will automatically check and initiate us itself towards monitoring of this one. By simply you are getting budgetary control mechanism, budgetary control statement, a printout or a soft copy, you will get what is happening, what was your target, what was your expectations, what happening. So this is an important task in budgetary control mechanism in management accounting as well as computerized accounting also. So this is regard to application of computers in management accounting area. You can simply get financial statement analysis, either it may be a common size statement or comparative statement. Common size statements confined for a single statement. You want to analyze a trading account of 2020. That's only. This is called as common size. Here, all aspects of trading and profit and loss accounts to be compared with the common figure, that is called as sales. Whereas balance sheet, total assets to be compared with individual assets, and total liabilities to be compared with the individual liabilities. This is common size statement. Comparative statement, taking more than two periods data or taking more than two companies data. There's trend analysis also there. If you want to compare the data more than a period of 2 years, then you are supposed to trend common size. In the sense, I am saying that common size statement of trend means you are comparing yourself. Trend comparative, you are comparing more than one kind of organizations, right? So you can simply get this common size statement, comparative statement, and trend analysis statement in a simple way and a single task way. Next one, ratio analysis. Many kind of ratios can be. You have some profitability ratios, you have some liquidity ratios, you have some consistency ratios, you have some solvency ratios, you have some efficiency ratios, you have some velocity ratios. Many kind of ratios can be get on a single statement by pressing a single item, single button or single command. Next one, cash flow statement can be prepared for a single day or for a period of selected time also. You can consider, prepare a cash flow statement on your own customization. You can get only cash in hand statement, or you can get cash in hand and cash in the bank also. And next one, funds flow statement. This is also one important task. You can prepare funds flow statement by applying computers in your management accounting area for gross funds flow statement. It will consider only current assets. Net funds flow statement, it will consider both current assets and current liabilities. And you can discriminate your current assets also. For example, prepaid expense is a current asset. It is a current asset, but it is not a quick asset. You want to prepare funds flow statement considering only quick assets. You can customize your software. Okay. Whereas current liabilities also can be streamed. If you wish to consider total current liabilities, you can. No. I want to consider only bank overdraft and short-term securities loan, something. Short-term liabilities to be paid immediately. You can prepare, right? So customization of your funds flow statement and cash flow statement can be easily possible. And report breakup, you can break up your report into a single day and single minute wise also. You can synchronize from January data to some far data like October data. Okay, you can together data in the form of synchronization. You can synchronize your data of various companies, various firms of your same company or various companies data if available also. For example, research students or research scholars wish to compare 5 companies data, then synchronization option is available in the computerized accounting area, right? So you can synchronize of homogeneity data or heterogeneity data. Next one, responsibility accounting. I'm saying that this is important aspect of management accounting, stewardship accounting, budgetary control, cost control, revenue control, any kind of tools available. So these are some values you can simply apply. Then management accounting, you have some marginal accounting techniques also there. Better budgetary control and monitoring, marginal costing and budgetary costing all considered as cost controlling techniques. Whereas process costing, contract costing, uniform costing, job costing, operations costing, operating costing, unit costing, all called as cost methods. Cost methods are those considered for computation of cost. Cost techniques are those considered for cost controlling mechanism. So you can simply apply marginal costing techniques by using this one. You have many more aspects in marginal controlling techniques, like break-even point analysis in rupees, break-even point analysis in quantity. You can simply get by pressing a single button. You have some contribution analysis. The ultimate residual after deducting of variable cost from the sales is called as contribution. Contribution analysis can be done by using this one. You have cost, volume, profit analysis, CVP analysis you can done in a single moment of time. You have some margin of safety analysis. My dear students, I am saying that all kinds of managerial, particularly managerial accounting techniques in the field of marginal cost techniques can be simply performed by application of computers in the so-called computerized accounting. So these are some important glimpses of computers in the area of management accounting. So management accounting is an important task for managers, particularly in decision-making process and target achievement process and realization of goals towards moving up objectives. So this is today's session. I hope you understand. If you have any queries, I'm sharing my name, my details in this academy. You can contact me digitally. Right? Hope you are doing very well. Stay safe and stay at home and stay safe. Have a nice time. We will be meeting in the next session in continuation of this topic regard to application of computerized accounting in other spheres of business world. Thank you.